Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ambal Mahalingam Engineering College, Coimbatore. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject heat and mass transfer. This is lecture number 207 on the module convection heat transfer. And today, we will solve few problems on the forced convection external flow. And in the previous lecture, we discussed the forced convection external flow, and we have seen many correlations for calculating the Nusselt number and then heat transfer coefficient, and then heat transfer. Also, we have seen the friction coefficient equation, Reynolds-Kalman analogy, and calculating the drag force on the flat plate. Now in this lecture, so we solve problems on the equations what we have in our forced convection external flow. So the learning outcome for the session, the student will be able to solve problem at the end of the lecture. And the steps to solve the problem on the forced convection, you read the problem carefully. Write down the given data and draw a diagram. Say for example, it is a flow over flat plate, flow over cylinder, or flow over sphere. These are all the three possibilities. Flow over a flat plate, flow on a over a cylinder, or flow over a sphere. You try to represent the data in the form of a diagram. And calculate the film temperature. So the film temperature equation is available in the data book. So TF equal to wall temperature TW plus T infinity divided by 2, and take the properties of the fluid from the HMT data book. So the popularly they will be giving the fluid will be air or water or any fluid. You can take the properties from the HMT data book, heat and mass transfer data book. Calculate the Reynolds number. So you take the Reynolds number equation for the flat plate, U infinity L divided by nu, or for cylinder of the sphere, U infinity D divided by nu. So classify the flow, whether you say whether the flow is laminar or turbulent. Then based on the type of flow, based on the type of the geometry, based on the value of the Prandtl number or type of the fluid, you take the Nusselt equation from the HMT data book for the laminar or the turbulent flow. So you calculate the Nusselt number, substitute the Nusselt number will be a function of Reynolds number and the Prandtl number. So substitute the values and calculate the Nusselt number. Then from the Nusselt number, you calculate the heat transfer coefficient. So Nusselt number equal to HCl by K or HD by K. So based on the geometry, so you calculate the Nusselt number. From the Nusselt number, you calculate the heat transfer coefficient. So once you got the heat transfer coefficient, we can calculate the rate of heat transfer. So Q equal to HA into delta T. So H is the heat transfer average heat transfer coefficient. A is the surface area for the convection, and delta T is the temperature difference between the fluid and the surface. Then finally, you write down the answer. So based on the question, you write down the parameter in the question or unknown in the question, and write down the answer. Summarize the answer. So you follow the steps for solving problem in the forced convection heat transfer or free convection heat transfer. So this is the heat and mass transfer data book, which is referred for taking the properties and the equations. So the heat and mass transfer data book by C.P. Kodandraman and Subramanian, that is permitted in the university examinations. And we take the example number 1. Air flows over a flat plate at a velocity of 10 meters per second. The air and the surface temperatures of the plate are 20 degrees Celsius and 58 degrees Celsius respectively. Calculate the amount of heat transfer per meter width from both sides of the plate over a distance of 40 centimeters from the leading edge. So the given data, velocity of the fluid, velocity of the air is 10 meters per second. T infinity is 20 degrees Celsius. TW wall temperature is 58 degrees Celsius. And the distance x equal to 0.4 meter. So you take the properties of the film temperature. So film temperature equal to TW plus T infinity divided by 2. So 20 plus 580 divided by 2 equal to 300 degrees Celsius. Now the properties of air at 300 degrees Celsius. So Prandtl number 0.674, thermal conductivity 0.04605 watts per meter Kelvin, and kinematic viscosity 48.2 into 10 power minus 6 meter square per second. So we calculate the Reynolds number for flat plate. Reynolds number U infinity x divided by nu. So U infinity is 10, x equal to 0.4, and the kinematic viscosity is 48.2 into 10 power minus 6. So the value is 8.3 into 10 power 4. Reynolds number equal to 8.3 into 10 power 4. And the flow is laminar. So the value is less than 5 into 10 power 5. So the flow is laminar. For laminar flow, constant wall temperature conditions, you take the Nusselt equations. Nusselt equation from the heat and mass transfer data book, page number 113, equation number 1.1, Nusselt number equal to Hx by K equal to 0.332, Reynolds number to the power 0.5, and Prandtl number to the power 0.33. And substituting the two values, 0.332, Reynolds number equal to 8.3 into 10 power 4, and Prandtl number is 0.674 to the power 0.333. The Nusselt number equal to 83.87. Then average Nusselt number, so from the page number 113, equation number 1.3, average Nusselt number equal to 2 into nu x. So the HL by K equal to 2 into nu L. So that is equal to 2 into 83.87 equal to 167.74. So the heat transfer coefficient, average heat transfer coefficient H equal to 167.74 into thermal conductivity is 0.04605 divided by L equal to 0.4 is equal to 19.31 watts per meter square Kelvin. So the average heat transfer coefficient is 19.31 watts per meter square Kelvin, and the heat transfer from both sides of the plate. So heat transfer is HA into delta T. Now we have to calculate from both sides. So 2 into HA into delta T, which is 2 into 19.31 into area equal to width into length of the plate, width equal to 1 meter, length of the plate equal to 0.4 meter into 580 minus 20 equal to 8650.9 watts. So the amount of heat transfer from both sides of the plate, from the plate to the air, is 8650.9 watts. So the heat transfer from both sides of the plate equal to 8650.9 watts. This is the answer for the problem. And we take the example number 2. Air at a pressure of 8 kilometers per meter square and a temperature of 20 degrees Celsius flows over a flat plate 0.3 meter wide and 1 meter long at a velocity of 8 meters per second. If the plate is maintained at a temperature of 78 degrees Celsius, estimate the rate of heat to be removed continuously from the plate. And the given data, velocity of the air is 8 meters per second, fluid temperature, air temperature is 20 degrees Celsius, surface temperature is 78 degrees Celsius, length of the plate is 1 meter, and the width of the plate is 0.3 meters. So properties of air, from the heat and mass transfer data book, page number 34 for air at the film temperature. So film temperature is TF equal to TW plus T infinity divided by 2. So 25 plus 78. So actually this is 78 plus 25 divided by 2, which is 51.5 degrees Celsius. And the properties, Prandtl kinematic viscosity, nu, Prandtl number, and the K. So here we have the property, and for 50 and 60 in the data book. So you write down the value and do the linear interpolation, and you take the value for 51.5. So for 51.5, nu equal to 18.067 10 power minus 6 meter square per second, Prandtl number equal to 0.6977, and k equal to 0.028365. And we calculate the Reynolds number. Reynolds number equal to U infinity L divided by nu. So 8 into 1 divided by 18.067 10 power minus 6, which is 4.43 10 power 5. So the flow is laminar. So the value Reynolds number is less than 5 into 10 power 5. So the flow is laminar. And for Nusselt number equation for constant wall temperature, so we use the equation page number 113, equation number 1.1 from the heat and mass transfer data book. And the same equation what we used earlier. So Nusselt number equal to 0.332 into Reynolds number to the power 0.5 into Prandtl number to the power 0.333. So Hcx by K equal to 0.332 into 4.43 into 10 power 5 to the power 0.5 into 0.6977 to the power 0.333 equal to 221.26. So Nusselt number equal to 221.26, and the average Nusselt number, it is 2 times of the NUX, that is 2 into 221.26 equal to 442.52. Then we calculate the heat transfer coefficient, average heat transfer coefficient, H equal to 442.52 into K divided by L, so which is 0.028365 divided by 1, which is 12.55 watts per meter square. And the heat transfer from the plate, so Q equal to HA into delta T. So H is 12.55 in 10 power, H equal to 12.55, area equal to W into L, so W equal to 0.3 meter, and the length equal to 1 meter. Delta T, T W minus T infinity, 78 minus 25 equal to 199.5 watts. So the rate of heat transfer from the plate is 199.5 watts. The answer to the problem, the heat transfer from the plate is 199.5 watts. So this is the answer. And we take the third example. Air at atmospheric pressure and 200 degrees Celsius flows over a flat plate with a velocity of 5 meters per second. The plate is 15 millimeter wide and is maintained at 120 degrees Celsius. Calculate the thickness of the hydrodynamic and thermal boundary layers and the local heat transfer coefficient at a distance of 0.5 meter from the leading edge. So you are given the properties now. Assume rho equal to 0.815 kilograms per meter cube, mu equal to 24.5 in 10 power minus 6 Newton second per meter square, Prandtl number equal to 0.7, and K thermal current equal to 0.0364 watts per meter Kelvin. So properties are given, then it is very easy. Write down all the properties. So T infinity is 200 degrees Celsius, U infinity equal to 5 meters per second, width of the plate equal to 0.015 meter, wall temperature is 120 degrees Celsius, X value equal to 0.5 meter, rho density, mu absolute viscosity, Prandtl number and the thermal conductivity of the fluid. Now the Reynolds number, so Reynolds number equal to rho U infinity X divided by mu, which is 0.815 into 5 into 0.5 divided by 24.5 10 power minus 6, which is 8.32 10 power minus 10 power 4. So the hydrodynamic boundary layer thickness. So this equation, so delta H equal to 5X into Reynolds number to the power minus 0.5. And this equation is very much available in the heat and mass transfer data book. So 5 into X equal to 0.5. X equal to 0.5 and the Reynolds number equal to 8.32 10 power 4 to the power minus 0.5, calculating the hydrodynamic boundary layer thickness equal to 8.6 in 10 power minus 3 meter, that is 0.86 millimeter. And thermal boundary layer thickness, again this equation is also available in the heat and mass transfer data book. So this is delta Tx equal to delta Hx into Prandtl number to the power minus 0.333, which is 8.6 in 10 power minus 3 into 0.7 to the power minus 0.333, which is 9.7 in 10 power minus 3 meter. And the Nusselt number equation for constant wall temperature conditions. So again, the equation is the same equation, equation number 1.1, page number 113 in the heat and mass transfer data book. Nusselt number equal to Hs by K equal to 0.332. Reynolds number to the power 0.5 and Prandtl number to the power 0.333 and local heat transfer coefficient H equal to rearranging and substituting 0.0364 divided by 0.5 into 0.332 into 8.32 10 power 4 to the power 0.5 into 0.7 to the power 0.333 equal to 6.19 watts per meter square Kelvin. So local heat transfer coefficient. Then the question, hydrodynamic boundary layer thickness is 8.6 in 10 power 3 minus 3 meter. Thermal boundary layer thickness equal to 9.7 into 10 power minus 3 meter. Local heat transfer coefficient is 6.19 watts per meter square Kelvin. So this is the answer to the problem. And example number 4, air at 273 Kelvin and 75 meters per second flows over a plate having 45 centimeter length and 62 centimeter wide. The plate is maintained at 90 degrees Celsius, assuming transition of boundary layer takes place at a critical Reynolds number equal to 5 into 10 power 5. Find the average values of friction coefficient and heat transfer coefficient for full length of the plate. Also get the energy dissipation from the plate. So the fluid temperature is 273 Kelvin, which is 0 degrees Celsius. Velocity is 75 meters per second. Length of the plate is 0.45 meter. Width of the plate is 0.62 meter. And the surface temperature is 90 degrees Celsius. So properties at the film temperature. So film temperature is 90 plus 0 divided by T equal to 45 degrees Celsius. And properties of air from the heat and mass transfer data book. So we have the data only for 40 and 50. So by interpolating, we take 45. So the 45, the properties are kinematic viscosity is 17.445 10 power minus 8. Prandtl number equal to 0.6985. Thermal conductivity is 0.02791. And density is 1.1105. Reynolds number, we calculate Reynolds number equal to U infinity L divided by nu. So 75 into 0.45 divided by 17.445 in 10 power minus 6 equal to 1.96 in 10 power 6. So the flow is laminar turbulent combined. So because it is given as critical Reynolds number is 5 into 10 power 5. So up to 5 into 10 power 5, the flow is laminar. Then after that, up to this end of the plate, it is turbulent flow. So the flow is considered as laminar turbulent combined. So the average friction coefficient for laminar turbulent combined flow, again from the heat and mass transfer data book, page number 115, equation number 1.51, and CFL equal to 0.074 Reynolds number to the power minus 0.2 minus 1742 Reynolds number to the power minus 1. So substituting the values, CFL equal to 0.074 into 1.96 in 10 power 6 to the power minus 0.2 minus 1742 into 1.96 in 10 power 6 to the power minus 1. So CFL value, the average friction coefficient is 3.28 in 10 power minus 3. And average heat transfer coefficient, again for laminar turbulent combined, page number 115, equation number 1.52. So Nusselt number equal to Prandtl number to the power 0.333 into 0.0347 Reynolds number to the power 0.8 minus 871. So substituting numerical values, Nusselt number equal to HL by K, so which is 0.6985 to the power 333 into 0.0347 into Reynolds number is 1.96 in 10 power 6 to the power 0.8 minus 871 equal to 2555.5, and calculating the heat transfer coefficient, H equal to 158.5 watts per meter square Kelvin. So from this equation, H equal to Nusselt number into K divided by L. So heat transfer from both sides of the plate. So the Q equal to 2 into HI into TW minus T infinity, which is 2 into 158.5 into 0.45 into 0.62 into 90 minus 0 equal to 7960 watts. So the answer to the problem, average friction coefficient is 3.28 10 power minus 3. Average heat transfer coefficient is 158.5 watts per meter square Kelvin, and the heat dissipation from both sides of the plate, it is 7960 watts. And example number 5, castor oil at 25 degrees Celsius flows at a velocity of 0.1 meters per second, part of a flat plate in certain process. If the plate is 4.5 meter long and is maintained at a uniform temperature of 95 degrees Celsius, calculate the following. 1. Hydrodynamic and thermal boundary layer thicknesses on one side of the plate. 2. Total drag force per unit width of one side of the plate. And 3. The local heat transfer coefficient at the trailing edge. And 4. Heat transfer rate. Properties of the castor oil at 60 degrees Celsius, rho equal to 956.8 kilograms per meter cube. Alpha equal to 7.2 in 10 power minus 8 meter square per second. K, thermal conductivity is 0.213 watts per meter Kelvin. And kinematic viscosity is 0.65 in 10 power minus 4 meter square per second. And the given data and the properties, you write down. T infinity equal to 25 degrees Celsius. U infinity equal to 0.1 meters per second. L equal to 0.4.5 meter. And TW equal to 95 degrees Celsius. And the properties of the castor oil as given in the problem. You just write down the properties. Then calculate the Reynolds number, U infinity L divided by nu. So u infinity equal to 0.1, length equal to 4.5 divided by 0.65 into 10 power minus 4 equal to 6923. So the flow is laminar. So the value is 6923, very much lower than the critical value 5 into 10 power 5. So the flow is laminar. And the hydrodynamic entry length, hydrodynamic boundary layer thickness equal to 5 times L into Reynolds number to the power minus 0.5. So 5 into 4.5 into 6923 to the power minus 0.5 equal to 0.27 meter. And the thermal boundary layer thickness, delta TL equal to delta HL into Prandtl number to the power minus 0.333, which is 0.27 into 902.7 to the power. So the Prandtl number, equal to nu by alpha equal to 0.65, 10 power minus 4 divided by 7.10 power minus 8, 902.7. So now the thermal boundary layer thickness equal to delta TL equal to delta HL into Prandtl number to the power minus 0.333. So 0.27 into 902.7 to the power 0.333 equal to 0.028 meter. So thermal boundary layer thickness is very much thinner than the hydrodynamic boundary layer thickness. So this is for oil, where the Prandtl number is very high. So for Prandtl number, very high Prandtl number, thermal boundary layer thickness is very much lower than the velocity boundary layer thickness. So the Nusselt number for constant wall temperature conditions, equation number 1.1 from page number 113. So the HL by K equal to 0.332 into Reynolds number to the power 0.5 and Prandtl number to the power 0.333. And calculating the local heat transfer coefficient, HL equal to 0.213 divided by 4.5 into 0.332 into 6923 to the power 0.5 into 902.7 to the power 0.333 equal to 12.6 watts per meter square Kelvin. And the average heat transfer coefficient is 2 times of the local heat transfer coefficient. So 2 into 12.6 equal to 25.2 watts per meter square Kelvin. And the heat transfer rate is Q equal to HI into TW minus T infinity, which is 25.2 into area is width into length into width. So 4.5 into 1 into 95.25 equal to 7938 watts. And average drag coefficient, so CFL equal to 1.328 into Reynolds number to the power minus 0.5. So this equation is also available in the Heat and Masters data book. And this equal to 1.328 into 6923 to the power minus 0.5 equal to 0.016, the average drag coefficient. Then the local total drag force equal to area into CFL into rho u infinity square by 2. So 1 into 4.5 into 0.016 into 956.8 into 0.1 square divided by 2, which is 0.34 newton. So the drag force equal to 0.34 newton. So the answer to the problem, hydrodynamic boundary thickness is 0.27 meter, thermal boundary thickness is 0.028 meter, the total drag force per unit width of one side of the plate equal to 0.34 newton, local heat transfer coefficient at the trailing edge equal to 12.6 watts per meter square Kelvin, and the heat transfer rate equal to 7938 watts. So this is the answer to the problem. You have the practice of consolidating the answer at the end of the solution. And we take one more example, example number 6. An aeroplane flies at a speed of 450 kilometers per hour at a height of where the surrounding air has a temperature of 1 degree Celsius and a pressure of 65 centimeter of mercury. The aeroplane being idealized as a flat plate, 6 meter long and 1.52 meter wide, and is maintained at a temperature of 90 degree Celsius. If the flow is made parallel to the 1.2 meter width, calculate the heat loss from the wing and drag force on the wing. And the given data, temperature of the air 1 degree Celsius, velocity is 450 kilometers per hour, which is 125 meters per second. Length of the wing is 6 meters, width of the wing is 1.2 meter, and the surface temperature is 19 degrees Celsius. So the film temperature is TW plus T infinity divided by 2, which is 19 plus 1 divided by 2 equal to 10 degrees Celsius. Now the properties of air at film temperature, 10 degrees Celsius equal to rho, density is 1.247, kinematic viscosity 14.16 10 power minus 6, Prandtl number equal to 0.705, thermal conductivity is 0.02512 watts per meter Kelvin. We calculate the Reynolds number. So Reynolds number equal to U infinity W divided by nu. So the W, why we take the W here? So the flow is made parallel to the 1.2 meter width. So the length of the length for Reynolds number calculation is W. So U infinity W divided by nu equal to 125 into 1.2 divided by 14.16 into 10 power minus 6. This equal to 10.59 into 10 power 6. So the flow is turbulent. So it is 1.059 into 10 power 7. The flow is turbulent. The average Nusselt number for turbulent flow, Nusselt number equal to HW by K. So instead of L, we are using W. So 0.037, Reynolds number to the power 0.8 and Prandtl number to the power 0.33. And the calculating average heat transfer coefficient, so H equal to K by W into 0.037, Reynolds number to the power 0.8, Prandtl number to the power 0.33. So H equal to 0.02512 divided by 1.2. Into 0.037 into 10.59 and 10 power 6 to the power 0.8 into 0.705 to the power 0.33 equal to 287.6 watts per meter square Kelvin. So heat transfer coefficient is 287.6 watts per meter square Kelvin. And the rate of heat transfer from both sides of the aeroplane wing, so 2 into HA into TW minus T infinity, just 2 into 287.6 into area equal to 6 into 1.2. Into 19 minus 1 equal to 74.55 kilowatts. The rate of heat transfer is 74.55 kilowatts from both sides of the wing. And the drag coefficient for the turbulent flow, so this equation also from the data book, CFL equal to 0.45 divided by logarithmic of 10 Reynolds number to the power 2.584 minus 8700 divided by Reynolds number. This equal to CFL minus 0.45. CFL is equal to 0.455 divided by logarithmic of 10.5 and 10 power 6 to the power 2.584 minus 8700 divided by 10.5 and 10 power 6, which is 2.13 in 10 power minus 3. So calculating, this is the drag coefficient is 2.13 in 10 power minus 3. And the total drag force on both sides of the wing, so 2 into W into L, CFL into rho into U infinity square by 2. And this equation is also available in the Hidden Marshall's data book. Otherwise, drag force equal to area coefficient, area drag coefficient into the rho U infinity square by 2. So substituting 2 into 1.2 into 6 into 2.13 into 10 power minus 3 into 1.247 into 125 square divided by 2, which is 299 newton. So the total drag force on both sides of the wing equal to 299 newton. So the answer to the problem, the total drag force is 299 newton and the heat transfer rate is 74.55 kilowatts. So that is the answer to the problem. So we stop here, and these are all the books I referred for preparing the notes. So you can also use it for your for further information. I have published a book on the subject. You can refer to it for additional information or additional numerical example. And if you have any queries on the subject, you can write to me, to my mail ID. I will sincerely answer to all your queries. So thank you. We'll meet again.